Hello friends. So welcome to the lecture on regularization of ill-conditioned systems. So in the last lecture, we have learned about the ill-conditioned systems, and we have seen if the conditional number of the coefficient matrix is quite large, then system is ill-conditioned, and if we solve such system as such, then the solution is not that useful, because if we are having a small error that may be due to sensor or due to computer, we can get a very large deviation in our final solution. So we are not sure about the whether the solution is correct or not. So in this lecture, we will learn regularization of ill-conditioned systems, means how to solve ill-conditioned systems by defining a suitable regularization term. So if you recall last to last lecture, there we have learned if we are having a system x equals to b with singular value decomposition of a as u into s into v transpose, then least square solution of this system is defined as x minus b, and by making some calculation and defining z equals to v t x, we have seen that z I equals to u I t b upon sigma I for I equals to 1 to up to r, and arbitrary for I equals to r plus 1 up to n. Later on, by seeing that the norm of z equals to norm of x, we have written the least square approximation of x as summation I equals to 1 to r, where r is the number of non-zero singular values, u I transpose b upon sigma I into v I. Now, just look here, it will become u 1 transpose b upon sigma 1 into v 1, u 2 transpose b upon sigma 2 into v 2, plus some u I transpose b upon sigma I, plus up to u r transpose b upon sigma r, and here v I and here v r. Now, if any one of sigma I, if one of the sigma I is small, or I will say is very small, then a small change in B gives a large change in the solution x star. This is why, because B is numerator and sigma I, which is very small, close to 0, is in the denominator, and you, if you will divide something with a very small value which is very close to 0, you will get a large change. And that is why you know that conditional number is sigma 1 upon sigma r, means the biggest singular value upon smallest singular value. And if it is very small, this is quite large and system is ill conditioned, and the same kind of analysis we can make here. If sigma r is very small, if you make a small change in B, you will get a large change in x star, means your system will be ill conditioned. Now, how to avoid this problem of ill conditioned system, that we will learn in this particular lecture. So, regularization. of ill conditioned system. So, consider an ill conditioned system x equals to b, where sigma 1 over sigma r is quite large, okay, where sigma 1, sigma 2, sigma r is the smallest singular value of A. Then it might be useful to consider the regularized least square solution instead of the earlier one. Here earlier one means which we have learned in previous lectures. So, this solution is defined as you just find out x which minimize 1 by 2 times norm of x minus b, plus here we are having a regularization term. So, now instead of minimizing this only which we have taken in the earlier case, we are minimizing this whole thing. What will happen when you will minimize the norm of x? It will stop to have a large deviation in the x, and hence your solution will not be having the large change. So, this particular term is called regularization term, and this kind of regularization is called Tikhonov regularization. Which is quite popular in regularization theory. So, here I am telling it in terms of linear systems, in terms of matrix analysis. So, here this particular parameter lambda will be a positive real number, and it is called the regularization parameter. Which is not known a priori and has to be determined based on the problem data. We will learn how to determine it by taking an example. Now we have to minimize this particular function. Let us say this equation 1. So, now minimization of half norm x minus b plus lambda by 2 the norm of x, and will be equals to, I can write this minimization of a root lambda I into x minus b 0. So, both of these are similar. So, let us say it equation 2. Now, for lambda greater than 0, so if lambda is non-zero, what will happen? The size of matrix A root lambda I will be, means it will be having m plus n number of rows, m from a n from I, because I is a n by n identity matrix into n number of columns, and H always full rank. Full rank means n, because even though if A is 0, I is a n by n matrix. So, the rank of this matrix will be always n, and you are having a rank n coefficient matrix, and X is having n number of unknowns. So, you will be always having a unique solution. So, the regularization system 2 has a unique solution always. So, now how to find out this unique solution? So, we have learned in a lecture, if you are having a system X equals to B, where A is a rectangular matrix, then the least square approximation of this A will be A transpose A into X equals to A transpose B, and from here X will be written as A transpose A inverse into A transpose into B, which is the pseudo inverse of A. So, in the same way, now the normal equation, so this is called a normal equation to this system. So, now the normal equation to regularized system 2 can be written as A root lambda I transpose, because like A X into equals to B. So, here A is replaced by A root lambda I into A root lambda I into X equals to A root lambda I transpose into B 0, or this can be written as A transpose into A plus lambda I X. So, this is the left hand side equals to A transpose into B. Okay. If I take the singular value, if the SVD of A equals to U SV transpose, then this I can write U S V transpose into A. So, A will become U S V transpose plus lambda I can write V into V transpose time X equals to U S V transpose into B. So, what I have done, wherever I am having A in this normal equation, I am writing its singular value decomposition. So, from here, if I write this U S V transpose into U S V T. So, this can be written as V S transpose into U transpose, because A B C transpose is C transpose B transpose A transpose into U S V T. So, U 2 into U will become I, because U is an orthogonal matrix. So, this can be written as V S T S into V T. So, this system I can write V STS plus lambda I into V transpose, and this into X equals to what I am having here, V ST UT B. Now, if I pre-multiply this particular equation by a matrix V transpose, then this will become V transpose into V equals to I. So, STS plus lambda I into V transpose X equals to V transpose into V will become I ST UT B. Now, put VTX equals to Z as we have done in the earlier case. So, then it can be written as STS plus lambda I into Z equals to ST UT B. Now, if you look at this matrix, it is a diagonal matrix, because S is a matrix which is having non-zero values only at few of the diagonal. So, STS will be a square matrix having non-zero values if they are at the diagonal, main diagonal only. So, then the solution ZI can be given as here sigma I due to this S transpose, then UI transpose into B upon STS will become sigma I square plus lambda for I equals to 1 to up to R, and it will be 0 for I equals to R plus 1 up to N. Here, if I calculate the least square approximation in the same way which I have done earlier, it will become summation I equals to 1 to R, if I is having R non singular values, sigma I UI transpose B upon sigma I square plus lambda into VI. Now, in the earlier case where we have not used the regularization term, I obtained this solution as I equals to 1 to R UI T B upon sigma I into VI, and in the regularized case I am obtaining this solution. Now, if lambda is tending to 0, in this case this particular solution put lambda equals to 0. So, sigma I will cancel sigma I square, this will become this particular solution, means lambda equals to 0 means we do not have the regularization term. So, this is the same solution but with the regularization term. Now, how this solution is useful? Even though if a sigma I is very small, okay, you can find out a suitable lambda, so that if you make a small change in B, it will protect to having a large change in the final solution due to the choice of lambda. So, here what I can say, so what I can write here, adding lambda by 2 means this regularization term to the ordinary least square . So, this term acts as a filter, means contribution from singular values which are larger relative to the regularization parameter, means the sigma, those are greater than lambda, are left almost unchanged, means you will get this kind of solution. And whereas you are having small sigma when compared to the lambda, the solution will be, this particular complete term will be treated as 0. So, I can write this particular term as sigma I u I t b upon sigma I square plus lambda. This can be treated like as a filter and it will be 0 if you are having a singular value which is very close to 0, small singular values. So, there is no contribution from that term in the solution and it will become u I t b upon sigma I, means your ordinary least square, if sigma I is greater than lambda. Hence, we can protect our solution to have a large change, because the term which will give you large change, we have made the coefficient of that term as 0. So, there will be no contribution of that particular term. Now, question arises, how to choose lambda. So, here suppose the data are b equals to b x plus delta b. Okay. So, b x is a data without any perturbation and delta b that the possible perturbation in my right hand side vector b. So, then I can write my x e x as I equals to 1 to r u I t into b x upon sigma I into v I, or this should be right as b. So, this is the, yeah, like this. So, this is the minimum norm solution of ordinary least square with unperturbed data right hand side vector. So, this will come in this form. Now, but we can only compute b. We do not know how much perturbation is there in the b. Okay. That is b x plus delta b. Since we do not know b e x. Now, the solution of regularized linear least square problem is x star equals to I equals to 1 to r sigma I u I t b upon sigma I square plus lambda plus sigma I u I t into delta b upon sigma I square plus lambda into v I. So, here I have written the regularized linear least square b, I have written as b x plus delta b. Here we observe that I equals to 1 to r sigma I u I t b e x upon sigma I square plus lambda tends to x e x as lambda tends to 0. Means whenever lambda is going to 0, your regularized linear least square solutions becomes the solution of the ordinary linear least square. On the other hand, we can see sigma I u I t into delta b means when perturbation in b upon sigma I square plus lambda will be approximately equals to 0 if sigma I is very very small to lambda, and this is as the ordinary least square if sigma I mean singular values are quite greater than lambda. So, these two facts suggest us, so we suggest to choose lambda sufficiently large to ensure that delta b in the data are not magnified by small singular values. So, in this way, by choosing a suitable lambda, if you know the singular values of the matrix A, choose lambda somewhere which is greater than some of the small singular values, so that the contribution due to those small singular values will be neglected in the regularized least square approximation. So, in this lecture we have learned how to perform regularization, or in this lecture we have learned Tikhonov regularization of the linear systems. We have learned how to choose regularization parameter, and we have done the analysis of the regularized least square approximation based on the singular values. These are the references. Thank you very much.